Hello everyone, welcome back. My iPad recently stuck on the Apple logo many times for no reason, it's very annoying. So I check it out, and I find 3 methods to fix it. But it is only for software problems. So if your iPad hardware is damaged, you need to go to the Apple Store to look for help. Method 1. Force restart iPad. Press the power button and the home button at the same time. Keep pressing till the Apple logo appears. Then you can release it. If it goes right, it should be normal again. If it is not, then it might be go back to Apple logo again, like this. Then you should follow the next 2 methods. Method 2. Update iPad with iTunes. iTunes can fix this issue sometimes. Connect your iPad to a PC or Mac. Then open iTunes. We need to put the iPad into recovery mode first so that we could update it. Press the home button and power button at the same time and keep pressing till the support interface shows up. Then you can release it and go back to iTunes. You should see it pop up a window that tells you your iPad need to update or restore. Here we need to choose update. Agree on all those agreements. Then it will start download firmware. It will take maybe half hour. So I will skip it. When the download is finished, it will start updating your iPad. When the update process is over, your iPad should be normal again. If it is not, or you have trouble with using iTunes, I recommend you a way more convenient tool. Follow the next method. Method 3. Repair with ReiBoot. This tool can repair more than 150 plus iOS system problems. Go check the download link in the description and download it. Once you downloaded it, open it. Connect your iPad to PC or Mac. If ReiBoot didn't detect your iPad, you need to put it in recovery mode first. Click the green Start button, then click Start Standard Repair. Here we'll require to download the match firmware to repair your iPad. Just be patient, it usually only needs 10 minutes, depending on your network condition. When the download is finished, click Start Standard Repair. The repair process will take some time. Do not disconnect your iPad during the process, or it won't work. Be patient, and it will be over soon. Then it is done. You can see my iPad is back to its normal state. I can access it without any problem, and none of my data is lost. Go give it a try. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you succeed in one of the methods. I'll be grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next videos.